Hello everyone, how's it going? Welcome to the YouTube channel of Petroleum from Scratch. I am Jayesh Char and this is Petroleum Data Analytics and Machine Learning Playlist. So in our last video, if you guys remember, we started a discussion about this new Python library known as Pandas, which will be used for storing your data and manipulating the data and making your data ready for feeding in some machine learning model or deep learning model. So in this video, we are going to discuss the major data structures that Pandas provides us. These data structures will be used for storing our data. And one more thing, these as Pandas is written on NumPy library. So basically these data structures are very fast. So Pandas generally provide two data structures. One is series and the second is data frame. These two data structures are present. Series is my one dimensional data structure and data frame is my two dimensional data structure. Basically two dimensional data structure means that it is present in kind of a tabular format, or just like you can say data frame is my Excel of Python. So now in this video, we are going to discuss some basics about data frame, that how does a data frame look like, what are the some properties of data frame. And we are going to discuss series, how some series can be formed, as mainly in industry, more data frame is used. So we will keep our focus more on data frame and we will give up, we will have a good understanding about series. So basically a series is a one dimensional data structure and data frame is two dimensional data structure. And what happens in data structures that in higher dimensional data structures, these low dimensional data structures are present. So in data frame, series will be present. So let's start our discussion without any further delay. So data frame, first of all, what is a data frame? We will have a technical definition for a data frame. So a data frame is a 2D size view table. Understand each word, what this stands for. Two dimensional. Yeah, I can see there are rows and there are columns. Size view table means that you can change the size of your data frame. You can add new columns. You can add new rows. You can delete columns. You can delete rows. Potentially heterogeneous, meaning that it can store numbers, it can store floats, it can store integer values, it can store string values, it can store time series data. So heterogeneous data can be stored in this tabular data structure with labeled axes. My axes are rows and columns, and these axes are labeled, means that your rows will be labeled by some index, whether it will be a simple index number, or you can say you can also define some other index also. You can label, you can give some names to your index for a certain row. In a similar way, your columns are also labeled. Columns will be labeled by column names. Okay, if you can see here, this is an example of a data frame. How does a data frame looks like? Again, thanks for Geeks4Geeks website for providing this image. This has been used from Geeks4Geeks. You guys can also visit Geeks4Geeks. It provides some good tutorials, good concepts regarding these Python and all these libraries. Not only data science libraries. Also, you can have certain more topics regarding different coding languages, including from Java, HTML, and all those things. So here you can see the rows are present and the columns are present. It is basically a sports data of some sports. I don't know which sport it is. Maybe it is for basketball. So here you can see it is a sports data for a team, where you can see these rows are present and columns are present with columns names are present. So these columns names are labeling my different columns. And in rows, this index number has been labeling my rows. But what you can do, you can also use this name of players for labeling your rows. You can just set this name column as your index. That we are going to discuss in our further coming videos. We are going to cover each and everything regarding this data frame, because this data frame, understanding this data frame and its properties of Pandas are very important in data manipulation also. When in the initial stage of your machine learning project, you get some data from your client or from your boss, and then you need to understand the data. You have to spend a lot of time with your data. You also need to manipulate the data a lot, because in initial raw data, there will be certain things that you need to take care. There will be null values, there will be outliers, maybe some data points are also wrongly mentioned. So all those things need to be take care. And you cannot open the Excel or CSV or Excel or CSV file for doing that. You need to do all those things in your Python only. So for doing those things, helping you to do those things, Pandas comes into picture. So we are going to discuss all those things. So basically, as you can see from this picture, my data frame, Pandas data frame, is nothing but just look like a tabular structure. It is just like an Excel sheet. If you can imagine, yeah, it is just like an Excel sheet here. Data frame is basically a Excel of my Python language, Python coding language. Okay. So again, yes, there will be rows and columns. So basically, a Pandas data frame consists of three principal components, the data, rows, and columns. Here you can see these are my rows, these are my columns, and all these points that are present, these are my data. So we will start how to, we will discuss how to construct a data frame, how to make a data frame. In this video, we are going to limit our discussion regarding data frame only, because we are going to discuss in depth about series. Practically, I'm talking about practically, we will limit our discussion regarding data frame. From the next video onwards, we are going to discuss all the properties, all the functions of data frame, all the functions of Pandas that are present for to be used in a certain, making certain data frame or handling certain data. So my first step will be importing Pandas. So I am importing Pandas as PD. Again, PD is nothing but my industry standard alias that is used for representing Pandas. And again, now for forming, for constructing a data frame, there is this function present in Pandas that is pd.dataframe. This data frame function here, just remember this one thing, that my D and F both are capital. In my initial days of learning these things, learning data analysis, I used to make a lot of mistake in regarding this capital D and capital F. So always remember, in my Pandas data frame function, my D and F are capital. Okay, so there this is Panda data frame function present, pd.dataframe. And inside that, what I have done, I have just given a list of certain names. I have given a list that consists of my name, petroleum from scratch, and I also added a new row that is data. Okay, and after that, I have given other parameter, that is my columns parameter that is present in this Pandas data frame function. And for column parameter, what I have done, that I have set my columns name as name. So when I'm going to run this block of cell, here this data frame has been made. This tabular structure has been formed, in which I am only having this one column, name, this name column, and which consists of three rows consisting of my name, petroleum from scratch, and data. So this is my column name, and this 0, 1, 2, these are my indexes. You can also change indexes as there is this index parameter present in this data frame function. So as there are three rows, so we need to provide three names or three things for my indexes. So let us say I'm providing A, B, and C. And I'm going to run this. Here you can see my indexes has been also changed. Again, guys, we are going to discuss all these things in detail in our, from our next video. It was it is just to show you how a data frame can be formed in Pandas. Now comes my next data structure, next important data structure, that is my series. So basically, series is a one-dimensional array-like structure with homogeneous data. Okay, so it will be one-dimensional structure, and the data need to be homogeneous. Means if you are having string values, then all the values need to be string. If you are having float values, then all the values need to be float. And basically, series is nothing. Your data frame are made up of series. As I said earlier, that best way of to think of this data structure is that the higher dimensional data structure is just a container of its lower dimensional data structure. For example, data frame is a container for series. So if you have a certain data frame, let us say you have a this data frame, this image you can see, this data frame is present. So all these name, team, number, position, age, these columns are nothing but your series. You can also make a series by using pd.series function that we are going to discuss. But first of all, moving on, before moving on to that, we are going to discuss this that how one column can be how what is the proof that this one column that is present in my data frame is series. So I have formed this data frame pd.data frame, the above data frame that I showed, and I have stored that data frame in my df variable. So when I'm going to call this df variable, you can see my data frame has been given as output. Here you can see this name column is present. And now if I'm going to see the type of this df variable, it is going to return me pandas.call.dataframe. So it is the type of data frame. Now what I will do when I select a single column of a pandas data frame, the result will be a pandas series. And how you can select the column? You can select the column by using square brackets. For example, in your NumPy arrays, we used to use these square brackets for indexing or for slicing the elements from your NumPy array. In a similar way, these square brackets will be used for this square bracket will be used to select a certain column from your data frame. Okay. For example, here this df was my data frame. I am writing df and square brackets, and inside that I have written name. So it is going to return me this name this name column. And here you can see I am getting a different type of structure. It is not a data frame because you cannot see this tabular form. You cannot see these different shades of white or this line. So it is a different structure. So what is this? What is the type of this structure? If I'm going to check the type of this structure, this is my pandas series. Here you can see it is my series. You can also name your series. This series also have name. And D type, it is showing that objects are present in my this series, because object is basically my strings are known as objects in D type form. Now this was taking a column from a certain data frame and checking that it is a series, but you can also create a series by using pandas series function. Here I have seen that you can create a series by using pd.series. Here I'm creating a series of porosities, different porosities value from different, let us say we are having different fields, different oil fields, and we are having different oil fields, and we have core sample from each oil field, and we have calculated the porosities from those core sample by using porosimeter. So I want to store this this data of porosity in something, and I want to store it in a series. So how to make a series of these porosities values? There is this pandas.series present function present, and inside that I have given a list of these porosity values, and I have stored this series in the name of a porosity variable. I have stored this series in my variable named as porosity. Okay, so I will run this code, and then I'm going to call this porosity anywhere, it is going to return me this series that is present with the D type. Here you can see float 64. Now what you can do, you can also provide name to this certain series. So when I provide name to this certain series, and in future, if I'm going to use this certain series to create certain column in my data frame, it will automatically give the name to that column. For example, here, now I'm going to provide this name. For example, in the above example, we have seen that we call this df name here, and here you can see that my name is equal to name. In the same way, I want to have certain name to this porosity data frame, porosity series. So there is this name parameter present in my series function. I will set the name is equal to poro. So when I'm going to run this cell of code and going to call porosity again, here you can see that my name of this series has been set to poro. So if I'm going to make data frame from this certain series in future, so what will happen, the name of the data, name of that certain column will automatically be taken as poro. Okay, so it will be useful in that. And on this this side here 0123, you are seeing the indexes for the series. In series also there are these indexes present for each rows. You cannot say rows, for each elements. As series are one dimensional data structure, but again in the one dimensional structure data structure of this series, indexes are also present. So what you can do, you can also change the indexes values. For example, I don't want to be indexes to set as this 0, 1, 2, 3. Instead, I want my indexes to be set on the field name from where the core sample has been collected. So what I can do, I can just write my name of my series and after that dot index. And after that, I passed four values for the four points, the four porosity values that are present. I have passed four values for my indexes. For example, I have passed KG Basin, Mumbai High, Pana Mukta, and Bangala. I passed the different field names of oil field names that are present in India for these porosity values. So what will happen then when I'm going to run this and when I'm going to call this porosity? Here you can see the indexes has been changed from 0, 1, 2, 3 to my field names. Now these field names are my indexes. And in a different method, you can also set indexes by this index parameter that is present inside my pandas series function. What I have done, I am making the same series. I have passed the list. I have named my series as Poro. And after that, I have passed index names. I have passed index names in this my index parameter that is present inside my pandas series function. And I have passed a list of different oil field names of India. So again, when I'm going to call this porosity, my output will be same as it is above. Okay. So this was about setting index inside series. Same things happen in our data frame also. You can also set indexes in data frame like that. Now, for example, I want to create a data frame using this porosity series. So for that thing to do, what I can do, I just write pd.dataframe, and inside that data frame, I've just given my input as porosity, the name of my series. And I'm storing this data frame in my variable named as pordf. So when I'm going to call this pordf, here you can see my output. A data frame has been created with indexes as field names. And my one column is present, one column of porosity is present for different porosity values for the core samples taken from these fields. So when I'm going to call, again comes here porosity, we are again coming to our series discussion. When I'm going to call porosity.index for my series, it is going to return me the index values of my series for different points. And when I'm going to call porosity.values, it is going to return me values for different indexes. So if you remember from your Python classes, from your Python playlist, that similar type of thing we also seen in our dictionary also, that dictionary are going to have key value pairs. Dictionary used to have key value pairs. In a similar way, if you see your series here, it is kind of key value pairs only. But instead of one key value pair, there are certain different key value pairs are present. So this series is more like, if you can see if you can compare it with the dictionary, so there are certain similarities present there. So for example, we will take an example here. I've created a dictionary for this same scenario. I've created a dictionary in which my key present different field names. And my value present viscosities for those fields. So I created this dictionary named as dicpor. And if I'm going to call this dictionary, you can see my dicpor look like this. It is having keys, it is having values. And now by using this dictionary, I can create my series. I can create my series. Again, by using pandas series function, just give input as my the name of my dictionary. And when I'm going to give it as input, and I'm going to call this series that is stored in POR variable named POR. Here you can see my series has been created. Now in this series, you have certain different functions or different methods present for this series function. For example, one of the method is the minimum for finding the minimum value. By using by writing the name of your series and writing dot min, it is going to return me the minimum value. That is my 0.23 for Panna Mukta. Apart from this minimum, there are certain more, a lot number of methods present. Just after writing the name of your series and dot, just click on the tab button on your keyboard and you can see different methods that are present for your different methods and attribute that are present for your series data structure. For example, this minimum we have already discussed, a lot number of different methods are present. ILOC is there, is in there, is null is there for seeing if there are some null values present in a certain series. Minimum is there, mean is there, you can find the mean directly by using this mean. So it is mean present. So all those things you can calculate by using these things. So this was all about series, and we also have a brief introduction in a data frame also, and we also see that how we can make how we can construct a data frame by using series. So in our next video we are going to start an in-depth discussion about data frame. I think series will be more than enough. It will be more than enough that we have discussed. It will be more than enough. So in our next video we are going to start an in-depth discussion about data frame. So see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye. Take care. Have a good day.